Once we finish drawing, it is highly possible that we will want to insert dimensions. There are different types of dimensions that can be found either in the dimension menu or in the annotation panel of the home ribbon. To see when we use each type of dimension, a few simple shapes have been created in advance. At first, I will select the linear dimension, which creates horizontal and vertical dimensions. A message prompts me to select the first extension line origin point, which in this example is the end point of the triangle's horizontal side. Once I click on it, another message prompts me to select the second extension line origin point, which is the other end point of the same side. Now, as I move the cursor up and down, the dimension moves along. I can place the dimension either above or below the line, so I will move the cursor below and click to finally place the dimension. Once I place the linear dimension, the tool deactivates automatically. Same goes for all the dimension options in the list. Now we'll press Enter to reactivate the linear dimension command, and I will repeat the procedure to insert a vertical dimension to the vertical side too. Notice that I can place the dimension either on the left or on the right side. This time I will place it on the right side. When it comes to inclined lines, such as the hypotenuse in the current example, the linear dimension will not display the length of the side, but the linear distance between the endpoints of the side. So, to display the actual length of this side, I will open the list with the dimension options and select the aligned dimension. Again, I have to select the first extension line origin point, which will be the first endpoint of the line, and then the second extension line origin point, which will be the other endpoint of the line. The length of the side appeared, and notice that the extension lines are parallel to the hypotenuse. I will click to place this dimension too, and move on to insert dimensions to the angles. From the available options, I will select the angular option, which measures the angle between selected geometric objects or three points. I will select the vertical side first, and then the hypotenuse. Notice that this angle is 35 decimal degrees. I will click again to place the angular dimension, and then I will press Enter to reactivate the angular dimension command. I will repeat the procedure for the second acute angle, selecting the horizontal side first, and then I will select the hypotenuse. Next, I will click to place the dimension. It's time to move on to the next shape to insert some more dimensions. The next option in the list is the arc length option. I can specify the distance along an arc or a polyline arc segment with this dimension. I will select it and proceed to measure the length of the fillet in the upper left corner of the shape. All I need to do is select the arc or the polyline, so I will click on the arc segment of the shape's perimeter. The dimension appears automatically, and I can place it where I think that it looks better by clicking once more. There are another two dimension options that apply to arcs, the radius option and the diameter option. Naturally, apart from arcs, those dimensions apply to circles too. The radius option measures the radius of a selected circle or arc and displays the dimension text with the radius symbol in front of it. On the other hand, the diameter option measures the diameter of a selected circle or arc and displays the dimension text with the diameter symbol in front of it. I will select the radius option first, and then I will click on the big circle. Once I clicked on it, the radius appeared and I have to decide the direction which I will place it. I will move the cursor around to experiment a bit and finally click to place the dimension inside the circle. Then I will open the list again and select the diameter option. I will select the smaller circle and click to place the diameter dimension outside of this circle. Before I move to the next option, I should mention that I can measure the chamfer's distances using the linear dimension option. So I will select the linear dimension and click on the endpoints of the sloped angle. Notice that if I move the cursor up, the horizontal distance appears. And if I move the cursor to the right, the vertical distance appears. I will place the horizontal distance first, and then I will repeat the procedure to place the vertical one too. The last option that I will show you from the list is the ordinate option, which measures the horizontal or vertical distance from the AutoCAD's origin point. I will click on the point that has been placed, move upwards, and click to place the distance of the point from the x-axis. Then, I will reactivate the ordinate dimension, move the cursor to the right, and click to place the distance of the point from the y-axis. In case you were confused about why the horizontal distance of the point appears vertically and the vertical distance appears horizontally, the following graph will help you get a clearer idea of this dimension option. Before we finish the lesson, I should mention another two useful dimension options that are not included in the list. Those two options are the continue and the baseline dimensions, which can be found either in the dimension menu or in the Annotate ribbon in the Dimensions panel. The Continue dimension creates a dimension that starts from an extension line of the previous or selected dimension. So firstly, before I select the Continue dimension, I will place a linear dimension to the first linear segment of the next shape. When I do that, I will activate the Continue dimension and notice that it starts automatically from the extension line of the linear dimension that I previously created. I will click on the end point of the next linear segment to place the next dimension and notice that, contrary to all the previous ones, this dimension option does not deactivate automatically. I can keep clicking on the rest endpoints to place the rest dimensions. In case I accidentally click on the wrong point, I can undo the last continuous dimension by clicking the Undo option from the command line. Once I place all the dimensions I want, I will press Escape to deactivate the tool manually. Last but not least is the baseline dimension, which creates a linear, angular, or ordinate dimension from the baseline of the previous or selected dimension. As you can see, a linear dimension has already been placed in the next example, so I will activate the baseline dimension and select the left extension line of this dimension. Notice that now, as I move the cursor to the right, the total distance appears. I will click on the end point of the next linear segment, and the dimension is being placed above the first one. Furthermore, it shows the total distance from the left endpoint of the first linear segment. This dimension option does not deactivate automatically either. In case I accidentally click on the wrong spot, I can select Undo from the command line. When I no longer need the tool, I will press Escape to deactivate it.